Shalom, good evening. The last session, we've been talking about this verse in Kohelet. Tov, Asher, Te'echoz, Baze, V'gam, Lize, Yadcha. It's good that you hold from this and from the other one, and also from the other one, don't hold your hand off.
Don't let go of this one.
The gam is there. Al tanach et yadcha. To continue, but we did only the gematria of Tov Asher Tocha Te'echoz Baze Vegam Ize. It's good that you all
that you hold this
and
also from
this.
That.
Before this, he said, "Don't be too much good." Then Tishomem, you know, you will stay Shmama, desert.
You will become desolate.
Amen. Yeah, you stay alone if you exaggerate of being a righteous man.
Right, don't be overly righteous.
And don't be opposite, too much alter sha arbe.
Don't be too evil,
right? Because then you will not live so much if you be. So, and then he said something that, you know, for a religion, it sounds a little bit strange.
For the religious.
For, you know, why? We have to hold the evil too. That is exactly what Shlomo is a donkey, say, in the book of Kohelet. It's a book of the paradox, more of any other book. It's a book of, really, it's a thing that is completely paradox. Right, and he finished the last word is Ra. The last word in Kohelet is the word evil.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it Kizekol Adam?
Sof davar akol nishmat Elokim irav et mitzvotav shemo Kizekol Adam. כי את כל מעשה אלוקים יביא במשפט על כל נעלם, אם טוב ואם רע. Then, the costume to say again the verse before, do not finish with something bad.
Right.
But maybe you like to finish with something bad.
We repeat the second to last verse so that we don't end up with...
They do the same thing in the end of the book of Malachi. פן אבו ויקטי את הארץ חרם. But cherem it's a donkey. It can be something very good. Cherem is like a taboo, a curse. He sent Eliyahu Hanavi to make peace between the father and the son. But if it's not going to work, I'm going to hit the land, the world, with a donkey, with a curse, you march more. Alright? It means if he's not going to walk with Eliyahu Hanavi, I'm going to send Elisha. Okay? This is what it means. Pen avo v'hiketi et haaretz cherem equals six times Aharon. We have six words. Aharon, it means the priest. When we say Aharon, when we say Eliyahu, it is the action of Eliyahu. It's what doing Eliyahu, and it is the soul of Eliyahu. It is two different concepts. We have to make a separation between these two things. Here you start to make with me a discussion. How come is this that equal Eliyahu? is a bad guy. We say that all this equal 1049. What equal Yitzhak Ginsburg plus Ariel Cohen Aloro. 489 plus 560. Okay?
Wow.
The Torah said it's not enough to learn just with Rabbi Ginsburg. And it's not enough to learn just with Ariel Cohen. You have to learn with both of them. Right? You have to learn from the good guy. And you have to learn from the bad guy. Right?
So you said Mizeh is Eliyahu.
Mizeh equal Eliyahu.
And Bazeh is David.
Bazeh equal David. When we have David and Eliyahu, so David is a good guy and Eliyahu is a bad guy. No.
Mm.
What is Eliyahu? You don't must be Eliyahu and Avi. To be Eliyahu. Eliyahu, it's a spirit. It's a ruach, like we said. Eliyahu Hanavi is a general spirit. So everybody have a spirit of Eliyahu Hanavi. Like everybody have a spark of Mashiach.
Right. Everyone has a spark of Eliyahu Hanavi.
Everybody have... What is the spark of Eliyahu Hanavi? Let's say we have now... We just have election...
Election
here in Israel, right? So I believe that somebody is good to be the king, right?
Mm.
So I do everything I can, so, you know, like the Chazir, that he will be a king, right? I devote myself for my rabbi, that he will be the king, right? It means Eliyahu equal son. Son, it's like somebody that go out from you, from the mother, and now you send him, Ben Meshulach. You send him, right? You send the son, you know, like the rabbi have many chassidim, have many son, have many disciples.
Mm-hmm.
And he sends them all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And we say to everybody, oh, how much the rabbi is great, they will tell all kind of story about the rabbi. This is the spirit of Eliyahu. Each one of them, it's a spirit of Eliyahu Hanavi.
Mm.
It means, it is written in the Zohar that somebody that don't think that his rabbi is Mashiach is not a real disciple.
Right.
Every disciple must to think that his rabbi is a Mashiach. If not, why you learn with him?
Right.
Go to the real thing. Right? If you don't think that your rabbi is the biggest in the world, you are not a real disciple. If you are serious with yourself, if you have the spirit of Eliyahu, you should learn with the best one.
Mm.
Right? If not, you just wasting your time. Well, we can learn all kind of stuff, but it is somebody that we are devoted to him. We say, we think that he's the great. Everybody have a rabbi like this.
Mm.
He can be wrong. But everybody should think that my rabbi is the best. It's why the disciple of Rabbi Shela said the name of Mashiach is Shiloh. And the disciple of Rabbi Yanai thinks that the Mashiach is Yinon. So everybody thinks that his rabbi is Mashiach. So is nothing in the halacha against that you think about anyone in the world that is Mashiach. According to halacha, you can think that Jesus is your rabbi and is nothing, it's not against the halacha. Alright? You know, just properly the halacha, you can think that your grandmother, she's Mashiach, no problem.
Right.
You can think that you are Mashiach too, no problem. Okay?
Right.
So, this is what you call the spirit of Eliyahu. All right, so is a rabbi, usually the rabbi is a good guy and the disciple is a bad guy. It is written in Kitvei Arizal that when a rabbi meet a disciple and teach him Torah, it is written that the rabbi, most of him is good and he have a little bit of bad in him. And the disciple, most of him is bad and he's a little bit good in it. Mm-hmm. So when they have this relationship of rabbi and disciple, the disciple will take from his, the rabbi will take from his disciple the few good parts that still are there. He will take them from himself. And the disciple will take from the rabbi all the bad spark he still have, and he will bring it to himself. If we thought that a bad spark, the bad is bad, it makes no sense what Arizal said. I learned with my rabbi to become more bad. But is that true? I took from my rabbi all the bad he have. Right?
So that
it's become very difficult for me to still find something that is interesting to me there, because this is what I look. If I'm a real disciple, if I'm a real Esa, but bad in a good sense of bad, it's been something that belongs to the world of chaos with a lot of light. What it can be considered to average people as a bad thing. They can think that it's bad, but it's very good. Better of good. Right? In the same way, my rabbi probably find in me some good quality. All right? So he took it for himself. All right? So
in the end, you end up you, all bad. The
bad has to be perfect in bad, and the good have to be perfect in good, and they are both good, and only when this separation is finished, they can make a wedding, they can meet again, and you know, have agreement together. Okay? It's like the separation between the day and the night. After you finish to do the separation, it's all one day. You make wedding between both of them. Right? After the separation is finished. So this is part of the separation that a disciple, a rabbi, teach a disciple. Now the disciple, if he's a real disciple, he thinks that his rabbi is the biggest in the world. So what he do with this? He must to tell to all the world that my rabbi is Mashiach. He must to do it. If not, he's not a real son. He's not a real Eliyahu. He's not a real Shaliach. Shaliach, it's like the Vav. Shaliach, it's a messenger. A vector of energy from here to another place.
Right, but if he's...
Shaliach with Yud equal Mashiach. It's been a son, that is a father. The secret of the stone is a Mashiach. The son must to be a father as well. And his rabbi, what is a father, have to become for him a mother. So who you send, really? It is written about Ken Tzipor, the nest of the bird, shalach et ha'em, send the mother, and take the son. You know, so usually the mother, it's like the surround light, and the banim, it's like really what we need. Usually it's explained, I don't need the mother. Send the mother away and take the son. But you can understand it differently. You make from your mother a son, Eliyahu. You make from your mother Eliyahu Hanavi. He called Yitzhak Ginzburg in order number Eliyahu Hanavi 120. You make from your rabbi a son. Because you are not just a son, you are a father too. And the mother, compared to the father, it's like a son. It's a generation below.
So how's that? I'm trying to
understand. Shalach et ha'em. Make from the mother ben meshulach. Make from the mother ben chacham a son that is wise. It means a son that is father. Yesamach av. He will make his father happy. But happy is a concept of a mother. Happiness. Em abanim smecha. Have the acronym of Isha. Ben Isha. Isha plus Ben. Isha plus Eliyahu equal Mashiach.
Okay.
Ben Chacham Eliyahu Anavi. Ben Chacham word by word equal Eliyahu Anavi. Yesamach, the letter of Mashiach. So a son that is father, that is wise, he make from his mother Eliyahu Hanavi, a son, a Mashiach.
So if it's a real disciple, though, he has to take into account that all the other disciples around have their Mashiach, their rabbi. So, meaning, how does... because you said a real disciple is someone who goes around, who will go around the world saying, my rabbi is Mashiach. What about everyone else's rabbi?
They're wrong. They don't know who is the real one.
Okay,
you have to be smart too. You cannot learn Torah if you are not smart.
Yeah.
Right? So the first rule in Torah, be smart. If you don't know who is the, you don't have the Tviat Ein. Tviat Ein,
the sense,
Tviat Ein, the sense of guessing who is the real Mashiach, who is the real tzaddik, who is the real rabbi. You don't have the capability of seeing the difference between the true one and the false one. It's like we have time to see it. It's a real goal or it's not, or it's a false goal. All right, so most of the people don't have it. We say about the blessing of the years that just passed, that we just finished, we say, Tehesh Nat Tviat Ein will be a year of Tviat Ein.
The eyes imprint.
Imprint, all right, the possibility to see.
The eyesight.
All right, so everybody have a sense to see the difference between a man and a monkey. And there are other people that don't see the difference and they think the monkey is a man. All right, so they say, this is my rabbi, he's my sheikh. So they will not be the winner the Book of Revelation talk about.
But there are many
disciples in Chabad. That says the rabbi is Mashiach, but one of them is a winner. In each community, it is one of that represents the winner in this community. Right?
It just creates, it's a very holy thing to believe that your rabbi or rabbi or teacher is the Mashiach.
You must. If not, why you learn with him?
Right, but then that creates war. It creates strife between people.
No, you have to be smart.
That their one is
You have to be smart. You have to know how to say it. There are many ways to. You have to make a plan. You do a plan. How to do it? You put all your life. You are devoted. This is the spirit of Eliyahu. I am devoted. I am all my life. Is to show to all the world who is my rabbi.
So you're saying that's the spark of Eliyahu?
That really is connected to Jesus in a way that nobody in the world is connected to Jesus, even he don't know it. Right? So this is what it means, the spirit of Elio. It means the spirit of the Son. Now each one is Son relative to somebody else. We say there are four Elio, there are four Son. Right? Even Jesus is a Son, is Elio. From who he receive? From who he receives the Spirit of God? From Amalek. You have to be really Jesus to be able to receive the Spirit of God from Amalek. Alright?
So what does that mean as people, as a person, to be living your spark of Eliyahu Navi? What does that mean for us? I mean,
besides... I write a book. I publish what he teach. I took what I think is the best of his teaching, not everything, because I'm completely different test of him. I take only his bad thing, and all bad thing is a fantastic thing, too much fantastic for the good people. So I take everything that in my rabbi is fantastic. It means it's bad. It's bad. It's from the chaos that is above the world of rectification, what is good. It's above. It's the big light. Right? So I take everything off my rabbi that is fantastic, and I put it in this book, and I want to show to this world, to the world, all this I learned from my rabbi. Right? So this is what I mean, the spirit of Eliyahu. It's not mean that I am Eliyahu Hanavi. I can be Elisha, I can be a pig, I can be a donkey, it doesn't matter, right?
So it's basically to be the messenger for, like Eliyahu Navi is like the messenger.
It's a messenger. For, a messenger, it's a son.
Right.
You remember when we learn, we teach about the cross in Parashat Vayetze. The parasha that Yaakov takes the stone from the well. Vayagel et ha'even me'al pi ha'be'er. Ha'be'er equal Yitzchak. Ha'even equal Chen. He took the stone from the mouth of his rabbi. Rabo equal Yitzchak, Habe'er equal Yitzchak. In the teaching of his rabbi, he is the key of redemption. What is Chen? And to be able to take the water of the well of the rabbi and to spread it all over the world, you must to be, first of all, to reveal something that if you don't reveal it, everything he teaches just stay sealed. You cannot teach it. Right? And this is the principle of Chen. Right? And then we saw how the key of Habe'er, of Yitzchak, to bring the water to the sheep, is a shepherd. Roe Tzon equal Haber Haber equal Yitzchak Yitzchak, etc. Yeah. It's why it is written Vayishak Vayashk Etzon Lavan Achimo. He give water Vayashk the sheep of Lavan, brother of his mother. And after Vayishak, the same letter, but in another sense, he kissed Rachel. Yes. Again, he want to bring the water to a big ship, an adult ship. Rachel, it means an adult ship.
Oh, an adult, an older ship.
It means Knesset Israel. It's not just one person. It's the whole unity of all the soul of Am Yisrael together. It's Rachel, the mother of Am Yisrael. Right? Doesn't matter. Always. Doesn't matter where you go to the two direction, secret of the cross. And then you get Yitzchak Yitzchak. So you are a real messenger. You don't lose energy when you go here. You don't get far from the one that sent you when you go here. You stay in the same place. Why? Because you go to the opposite direction. And then you reveal the two spirits, that it's all the idea of Elisha reveal the potential of his rabbi, Eliyahu Navi. Avi, Avi, twice, you twice, two times, Eliyahu, right? I want you twice. Why twice? Because I'm your father as well. I go to the opposite direction. Right, so this what it means, the spirit of Eliyahu. It's not mean that you are really Eliyahu Navi that reveal himself to the tzaddikim, etc. It's not mean this. Mm. All right? This is something general.
So if I'm a, let's say, a religious Jew, and I'm not a Yeshua believer, is there any way for me to still manifest being the spark of Eliyahu Navi?
I know that your name is Eliyahu, but
right, right. I mean, it happens to be, yeah. But is there still a way of doing that? Of
it's all relative. It's all relative. I mean, you know, my rabbi have a rabbi above him, and mm-hmm. my rabbi and the rabbi have a rabbi above him. Mm-hmm. It's all relative, right? So you have to find your place in a certain shine.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to be smart enough to recognize that it's a true trend mm-hmm. and not a false one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yeah.
Because most of the people have no idea where is the true, where is the lie.
But everyone thinks that their chain is the most true.
And you know? Sometimes can be a very, very high soul, but when the soul go down to this world through regular people, he receives bad clothing. The clothing of the soul is the marshava dibur maaseh, the thought, the speech, and the action, parallel to olamot bria yitzira asiya. So when the soul go down from the world of atzilut, let's say that it's a soul from Olam Atzilut. If you receive bad clothing, doesn't matter how much your soul is high, you cannot think, you cannot talk, you cannot do anything properly. Right? So then you think, it cannot be him. He's just a regular, he's not brilliant in nothing, this guy.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So to recognize the truth, it's not only to see how much he's beautiful. You know, it is somebody that have a nice face, nice body, look very well.
Right. No,
it's not mean that you have a soul of Olam Atzilut.
Right.
And you can be something else, like it is written about Mashiach, lo toar lo, have no beauty. That really we desire, we want it for us.
Hmm.
And you have no personality, really something that with a big charisma that you see, wow. No. So the Torah tell you, be careful. You don't look like even Shmuel, the prophet, saw the beautiful son of Yishai. Okay. The one that came before the David, and I think there are seven exactly, if I'm not wrong, right? David is the seventh one.
Mm-hmm.
We have another list of seven that we have to check. And he said, wow, what a beautiful sun. And God tell him, no, you look with your eyes, but you don't see the earth. You don't see the essence of the person.
Right.
I want somebody else. He's not here. Right? The most one that we thought that is the last one, Sh'era Katan. Shmuel didn't recognize. Even Shmuel, you know, somebody like Shmuel, he will see the, you know, the aura, have a big aura. I saw it's a spiritual with a lot of capi. He sees the spirit. Even this, it's not tell you the truth. You know, even you can see the thought of the person, how much he's organized. He never do mistakes. You know, he's really have a good clothing. He have a nice clothes, clean clothes. Don't say the truth. Right? So it's a sense to recognize who is the right righteous man, who is a really true rabbi of Am Yisrael. Right? You need a special tviat ein, like we said about the last year. Right. So this was just to explain what is the spirit of Eliyahu. Right? Now, we have other very interesting things that equal this number, by the way.
How did we get to this number again?
Yitzchak Ginzburg plus Ariel Cohen Aloro. Tov asher to te'echoz baze ve'gam mize. It's good that you all with this and with
right
the other thing also.
Right, but originally that this number, how did we connect to this? 1049.
We said it equal this phrase.
Oh, that's it. That was it. Oh.
Yeah, and we said it equal Yitzchak Ginzburg plus Ariel Cohen Aloro. What else equal this number? First of all, what was the name of the mother of David? Nitzevet Bat Adiel. See the way her name is written in the Gemara. To say that the mother of David, her name was Nitzevet Bat Adiel. The mother of David. Now, when we talk about the concept of mother, M, there are two concepts, like there are two letters. We call them Eldad and Eldad. Eldad is the male one. My dad is a female one, but both together are mother as well.
Right.
To be a mother, it means to have a process of, like a woman, of develop something. You have some idea about Mashiach, you have a point, you develop it. You develop it and you develop it.
Development.
Development. So everybody that do development is a mother. Even if we talk about a couple, a two guys, that both of them do development about the concept of Mashiach, one of them is more the one that gives the original idea, and the other one is more of the, just the development. Right? So this, we call them Eldad and Medad. So we give a lot of lessons about Eldad and Medad, the 41 generation, etc. Mashiach Eliyahu. When you say Mashiach Eliyahu, Mashiach is a good guy, Eliyahu is a bad guy. Again, it's like It's like a king and Eliyahu. Same thing. No must to be. Can be opposite too. Each one of them is Mashiach and is Eliyahu. The priest called Mashiach as well. Akoena Mashiach. All right, so. But when we talk about the classic understanding of Mashiach, it means somebody that really will be a king, it cannot be the priest. Priest cannot be the king. Mm-hmm. It's not allowed. Why? Because it's too much of Mashiach. Like a woman cannot be a king too. Why? Because she's too much of a king. Like a girl, a non-Jew that convert cannot be a king too, according to Halacha. Why? Because he's too much of a king. If you're too much of something, it's like you're a body.
A convert is too much of a king? How?
Well, the four Galgalei HaMerkava is Kohen, Levi, Israel, Ger. Ger is a kingdom.
Many
times. It's David. David came from Ruth, from the north, from the Ruth HaMoavia, that she was a Gioret. Right? All right, so when you are too much, and the kingdom is always female. It's mean a woman, she's natural king.
Right. Okay.
That's but funny. If you are too much of this, it's like to say that the body is God. The body is God, but it's too much. All right. Cannot be revealed as God. All right. If you are too much, it means it's too concentrated. And if it is too concentrated, I don't see the light anymore of the thing. We need the light of Mashiach. The light of Mashiach is not the body of Mashiach. It's the soul of Mashiach. It's Jesus. Okay? It's not Amalek that is above him, the Spirit of God. Okay, Amalek cannot be Mashiach. It's too much of Mashiach. All right. What else he calls this number? Halak. Ha'oded. Seir. The mountain, Chalak.
The smooth mountain.
That go up.
To Seir.
To the mountain of Seir. To the Seir. Seir is Esav. Chalak is Yaakov. So you have here, in very clear way.
You have Avram. You have, Ha'al is Avraham. Chalak is Yaakov. Ha'ole is like Ola, that's Yitzchak. And Seir is Esav.
Okay.
You have all four.
Okay. Right. Avraham is have to do. It's called. He calls
the temple a mountain.
Yeah. Right, but it's definitely. Yaakov say, "I am Ishchalak. I am a smooth one, and my brother is Seir."
Right. He's hairy.
He's hairy. So. This equal 1049. What else equal this number? Shela plus Tshuva.
Wow.
Question plus answer.
Wow.
Who is the question? Who is the answer? Purim equal question.
Right.
Purim, it's a question.
Right.
It's a holiday with a lot of questions. Everything is opposite, so there are a lot of questions. How we get to the answer from the question?
Well, Pesach has usually questions.
Well, we ask questions in Pesach, but Purim equaling Gematria question. Question, yeah. It means it's a problem. Hmm. It's a holiday with clownery. Why? Why clownery? Why to put costume, etc. So
it's a paradox.
There are many rabbis that they are so good that they don't understand this holiday at all.
Mm.
Right? So
right.
To be drunk, to drink, to become drunk, well, they don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So Purim equal a question. Question is like out of holiness, usually. Question. If you are in holiness, you have no question. To be in holiness, it means there are no... It is written in the Gemara that the question are from the other side. The concept of being instead of question, it means I have a doubt. I am not completely in holiness if I have a question.
Hmm.
So I must to find the answer. How we find the answer? Let's do Purim with the filling letter. Pei, Vav, Resh, Yud, Mem, equal Tshuva, answer.
Mm.
Purim. Okay? So, this plus this equal 1049. What else equal this number? The action of God plus Mechtav Elohim. These two impressions appear about the tablet of the Ten Commandments. No. The act of God and the letter or the writing of God. Who is a bad guy, who is a good guy?
I would say the writing is the good guy and the action is the bad guy.
No. Mm-hmm. You're wrong. A good guy is somebody that do commandment, he do good act of a righteous man. He do good act. I give you example that what it means to do good act. He don't do gematriot of his name, never. A bad guy will do gematriot of himself. Right? It's a bad guy.
Mm.
Right?
Right.
A good guy, you know, I tell you a story, a real story. It's happened 25 years ago, 30 years ago, I don't. Many years ago. We have a Verbrengen, it's Vahadut, with Rabbi Ginsburg and with his disciple.
A gathering of...
gathering together. And there was in the room three couple that just get married.
Mm-hmm.
Three different couples that lately there was... or going to be married next week, or already have marriage,
mm-hmm.
just 1 week or 2 weeks ago. There was yet still in seven brachot. Three different couples. Each one of the two couples, the gematria of the two names of the Chatan and Kala was Yitzchak Ginsburg.
Mm-hmm.
489. Three couples that each one of them, the husband and wife equal 489. It's a true story. And they were all there. So now, Rabbi Ginsburg start to teach about the number 489. And then I said, by mistake, I didn't know, I thought it's clear, so I said to everybody, Yitzchak Ginsburg. the rabbi become white. He have no idea that, and I ask him, you did know that 489 is the gematria of your name? He said, no. He never did the gematria of his name. Right? It means no ego. No ego at all. He knows that it's bad, so he don't do it. Right? I just give you an example. So this, you can call it the act of a righteous man. The act of God. It's an action. It's a way of behaving.
Behavior.
Now, I wrote 200 books. I wrote only one. But it is written, Michtav Elokim Hu. How much you call Michtav Elokim Hu?
So why is writing the a bad guy?
Right. Let's see. Oh. It is written Michtav Elokim Hu. How much you call Michtav Elokim Hu? 560. Right? So you have no doubt that this is a bad guy. The bad guy means the good guy and the bad guy both together. All, when you have both of them, always the dominant is the bad guy.
What's 560?
Ariel Cohen Aloro.
Oh.
The number we talk about. This plus this equal Yitzchak Ginzburg plus Ariel Cohen Aloro. 1049. It is written about the tablet, that is the act of God, and it is the writing of God. So we know the word who equal 1049. But if I want to know who is the writing of God, of Elohim, it is written the Michtav Elohim who equal 560. So I know very clearly that this is a bad guy. Alright? Is a verse in Tehillim 119, if I'm not wrong. No, it's not. I'm sorry. One second.
What's the verse?
Kigmul Yadav Yaselo Ami. This is not a verse in Tehillim. This is a verse in Yeshayahu 3:11, chapter 3:11. Kigmul Yadav Yaselo Ami Nokshav. What's special about this verse? We have here the acronym of the name of the organization of Rabbi Ginzburg, Gal Enai. Gal Enai. Gal Enai. Gal Enai, it's a verse in Tehillim, the book of Tehillim.
Right. Reveal my eyes.
Gal Enai Vabita. Niflaot mitoratecha. Right? So, Galenite, this is the name of the organization of Rabbi Ginzburg.
Right.
And I, many years ago, when I have in the computer a program that search for acronym, today I don't have it, I don't have something like this.
What happened to it?
This computer was you remember when the computer was green?
Yeah.
Right. So 30 years ago, he went away.
I'm sure they have this today, much much better.
I don't have yet.
Okay.
Right. They have an internet, but you cannot find all the permutation. Only the permutation you write. Right. So Gal Enai is. Six letter, So you have 720 permutations. Mm-hmm. Right, so I'm not going to try each one of them.
Right.
It's not in the right order. And I think it is only one like this in the Bible, if I'm not wrong. Only one Gal and I acronym in all the Bible. Maybe two, I don't remember. I think one. Mm-hmm. Right, so how much equal this five word? 560. Kigmul yadav yaseh lo. God will give him.
Will do unto him as his.
His action.
Yeah, as his action.
Usually it's a bad connotation. Gmul yadav, he will receive what he deserves.
Right.
But he receive what he deserves can be a good thing too.
Right.
Right.
Right. It means the reward.
The reward for his hand. If he have good hand and he do something good with his hand, so he will have a reward, a good reward. I mean, Okshav, it's more difficult to give it a good
translation.
Avin Okshav, he called Yitzhak Ginsburg. Avin Okshav, it's like power. It's somebody that give too much work to the people. Nogesh, it's like a policeman that make you work hard, Nogesh.
Yeah.
My people, the Nogesh of my people. It's like a policeman that hit you, that you work better.
Right.
Right? This is what the rabbi do. They give us a lot of commandment to do, right? They make the people work hard.
Isn't it Nogesh with a sin? Nogsav. Usually the Nogsim are the people that were...
Let me check. Yes, you're right. Ami Nogsav. Kigmul yadav yaseh lo Ami Nogsav. Okay? So Ami Nogsav, it's like Paro.
The oppressor.
Equal Yitzhak Ginsburg. And he will deserve what? He will receive what he deserves. Equal Ariel Cohen Alor. Okay? So we have here the acronym of the name of the organization of my rabbi. By the way, if we talk about name of organization, the name of my organization is Ufneem
Ish El Achiv.
Ish El Achiv. The name of the organization of my rabbi is Gal and I.
Yeah.
How much equal together? 3 plus Yitzhak Ginsburg. If I write Gal and I with filling letter.
Oh, it's two different verses, I see.
Gal and I.
Kigmul yadav yaseh lo.
Gimel. Lamed. Ayin. Yud. Nun. Gal and I. Equal Kohen plus Mashiach. One of them is a Kohen, the other one is a Mashiach. Jason Gal and I. So sometimes a rabbi have 50,000 disciples. But really, he have only one. Arizal said to Rav Chaim Vital, the one that wrote all his Kabbalah, all his teaching, that he came to this world only to teach him. And all what we know about all the Kabbalah of Arizal, it's only what we receive from Rav Chaim Vital. Most of it. Okay?
Right.
I saw even he have probably other disciples. In his time. Right, so...
So you're the only real disciple.
Like, Elisha is the disciple of Eliyahu HaNavi. Probably have many disciples. There was Bnei HaNevi'im, there was many disciples. Right? But Elisha is the main one. Okay, so... It's like a true relationship between father and son. Okay? It is somebody that is really a son of the father. It's when he really takes the essence of his teaching, he gets to the essence. And it is somebody else that don't get to the essence. Right? And take all kind of other stuff that might be very interesting too, but it's not the essence of his teaching. Right? A son, he receives the essence of his father. What you call the seed, the essence. For example, Rav Kook.
For example.
What was the essence of the teaching of Rabbi Kook? Eretz Israel. So his disciple...
The land of Israel.
His son, Tzvi Yehuda, Rabbi Tzvi Yehuda, Kook, he teach only about Eretz Israel. But Rabbi Kook teach about many other things. Rabbi, the rabbi, Avraham Yitzchak, HaKohen Kook, have a lot of teaching of Kabbalah, of all kind of different things,
right,
about the soul, about... He was really a big philosopher. But the son took only his essence. Really his essence of everything he teach, he was there at Israel. So he put all the rest aside. He didn't teach other thing besides Eretz Israel. The Torah that have to do with the land of Israel.
Right.
He's a son, so a son takes the essence of his father. Okay? So let's say that the essence of my rabbi is Chen. Right? He teach me thousand different Torahs about the word Chen. Right? So I take the essence. That have to do with Chen. And Gematiot is one of the essence thing with Rabbi Ginsburg. He's special with this thing, so I take the essence from him. All the other disciples, they don't like the Gematria so much. It's too much, all right? So they put it away. All right, so what else we have with this number? All right, so there are many other very nice things with this number, but these are main things that have to do, that we can see very clearly the concept of the good guy and the bad guy. Very, very clearly.